evening and welcome to John D'Angelo Gymnasium at Harvey High School for tonight's wrestling match between the Red Raiders of Harvey and the Spartans of Conneaut. Captains have just taken care of the coin toss. I'm joined tonight by Joe Hotta, former head coach at Mentor High School.
Well, Jeff, I think we have a very interesting match tonight. There are a couple of interesting points coming up. Coach Cancellosi, a longtime Harvey wrestling coach for over 30 years. It's his final home match, and I think it's always special, the last home match for the seniors. And, I think it adds a little extra purpose to it. You'll see the heart and determination come out with these men tonight.
I would agree, and as you said, this is going to be John's last match at home as head coach here at Harvey, and I'm sure these guys are going to try to put out just a little extra.
Now we're going to start this evening with Kevin Wright. There's a forfeit at one.
New rule this year, the coaches get together and draw for the opening weight class, and 130 was picked tonight. So Kevin's out there, and he starts it right out with a nice double leg takedown and an escape for Conneaut. Looks like he's getting pretty good penetration on the shot.
Kevin's experience, he did real well in the summer camps and worked very hard in the off season. It's really improved his takedowns. He has a good sense of the mat.
Trying to get a little limp arm here to score this points before, yep, out of bounds, we go back to our feet. Minute 26 left in the first period, it's still 2-1 Harvey. Awfully quick, Coach, awfully quick. That'll be two more on the high single, making it 4-1. Listening to his coach, Kevin kicks him out for the escape, makes it 4-2. Looks like he's pretty much having his way with this kid on his feet right now.
You know, Kevin's really strong on his feet. I think he's really improved his takedowns in the past year. A lot of confidence there. And, that opens up pinning combinations. Usually your opponent's going to, make a few more mistakes. He's worried about where you're going to be. And he loses self-confidence. So Kevin's doing a nice job.
Tough. I guess the knee must or toe must have hit that line for a second. Out of bounds. We'll come back and try it again.
Oh, nice low single.
Very quick shot. Ooh, looks like he might be able to grab a couple back points there for a second. Can hear the coaches tell him just keep it tight. Don't give up any points. 10 seconds left in the first period. A 6-2 lead. But Kevin's going to look for some back points here, it looks like.
He has an armbar in, and he's applying a lot of pressure to the head.
And there we have the end of the first period. He scores Harvey 6 and Conneaut 2. Kevin had his choice of position and defers to Conneaut. It's Matt Bidwell from Conneaut, a freshman. Bidwell took down, probably assuming he'd get a free point on the kick out here at some juncture.
I think with the forfeits tonight, you're going to have to take your experienced kids and create as many team points as possible. Get the technical falls, get the falls, and kind of make those points up so you're back in the game.
I couldn't agree more, and I guess we'll find out in about 30 seconds here. He may be better off trying to pin this kid off of the takedowns. I like his confidence out there. Got caught on his hip, never panicked. Gave up the reversal. That's going to make it 6-4. Coaches want a locking hands call there.
You know, I might agree with him on
that one. You know, taking the old official's perspective here, you got to give him that reaction time, Coach.
Yeah, there's a little reaction time. And, you know, I remember you sitting there going, hey, you know, I need my point there.
Nice.
Kevin hits a nice switch there. You know, he got movement. He changed the direction a little bit, came back and hit a switch. He set that up nice.
Yeah, didn't get that leg clear, though.
Well, he's
hasn't scored yet.
Right.
Uh-oh, this looks bad. Nice hip over. He kept locked in on that arm. Got Bidwell down to the mat and stepped right over it. Now he's getting the back points. There we go. This is what they need. Needed to catch that arm coming through. Picked up two more near fall points. That's going to run our score to 10-4. 12 seconds left in the second period on the out of bounds. To lift this kid up, yeah. Make an attempt to get him back to the mat within 5 seconds.
Well, one of the things you hate to do in that situation is give him 1 point.
Yep.
You know, Kevin did a nice job of keeping him in there.
Start of the third period, it's going to be Kent Harvey's choice. Looks like he's taking neutral. Wise decision. He really wants to try to get this nice penetration and set his pinning combination up off of the takedown.
Well, Kevin had a nice shot. Sometimes you got to be a little quicker on the finish.
Yeah, I think he sat just a split second long on the mat with that one.
In deep again.
It's just me. I think I'd probably try to go back to that double. Back out of there and nice little throw by. Now, quite frankly, some people might have given control there, even though his leg was overhooked, since he had Bidwell off of his base. As it is, we'll go back to neutral and try it again. Well, there's something we haven't seen tonight, a shot by the Conneaut wrestler. Kevin needs another 2 points to get into the bonus situation here. Kind of a lazy shot.
Kevin, you know, got caught with his head down, and the Conneaut wrestler, Bidwell, was able to put a front quarter on and get behind it.
Suddenly he's caught sitting on his...
We have about 30 seconds left here, and it's a 4-point match.
And Kevin, if he'd come up and scoop that head right now, he could probably pick up 4 quick ones.
This one could be stalemated out for the rest of the match.
Anytime now, yeah. Looks like it's gonna. And there's your final buzzer. And Kevin Wright takes a 10-6 decision over Matt Bidwell from Conneaut. Next up here, we're going to have one of Harvey's team captains, 135-pounder Lucas Gibson. Lucas is one of the seniors on the team this year. Uh-oh, wait a minute.
That's an
In an unexpected turn of events, Kanias forfeited to Lucas, which I don't really understand. They're giving him the 6 points he would have earned had he pinned whoever they sent out there against him anyhow. But a little bit of strategy there. Senior Lucas Gibson gets a forfeit.
Yeah, you always want that senior to get a match his last home event.
Yeah.
And I'm sure Lucas is disappointed with that. We have Stephen Portick wrestling now.
Sophomore, 140-pounder. Stefan broke into the varsity lineup this year for the first time and has actually been improving a lot over the last month here. He's had a nice January, starting to get some confidence in himself.
Portick was attempting a front headlock.
I might throw in here, Stefan is a third-year wrestler. He didn't come to the sport until eighth grade over at the junior high, so you may see a little bit of inexperience play into this tonight, but he's going right after the kid.
He's wrestling a senior who has obviously a little more experience.
Match the bow.
Kanyat's ahead now, 2-0 with the takedown. He tries a tilt, and the official does Ooh. Give him 2 for the near fall.
Kind of a quick 2 there.
And I think he started to count that from the other side of the mat.
Stefan just needs to keep fighting that head up. That was an illegal headlock momentarily with no arm included.
But Jeff, you're looking at the point from the official. I'm looking at the point of the wrestler here. So.
Yeah. Of course, you get that call. They take Stefan off his back, and
right.
We get to start again.
Kev, I'll tell you what. Stefan's a fighter. He really.
And he's got those great hips that you can't teach. You get a little bit high on him, he'll flip you right over.
Stefan always gives you everything he has here.
Well, we can see plenty
okay.
of way to hold off. So, 3-point near fall is going to take our score to 7-0 in favor of Brandon Hale from Conneaut.
I think an important thing here for Stefan is to stay in the match. He still has 4 minutes left. And use his techniques, use his style, and chip away at these things. He can come back in this.
He wants to make sure he maintains his quickness out there on his shots, too. I don't think he wants to get caught on his knees with this kid again.
It was a nice shot to the outside single.
Very low single. I think he finished on the toe. Okay, so we saw Mr. Hale throwing a very illegal arm bar, and that was illegal because he took the palm of the hand up to the shoulder and put the force forward. That's going to cost him a point, so that's going to take our score to 9-1 here. Stefan's checked that his shoulder's still attached, and he's going back to the middle of the mat. Optional start from Hale, give him the 1 point so he can go takedowns again. I think Stefan wants to stay outside and stay quick on this kid. No tie-ups here.
I think the coaching staff pointed out to him that they didn't want him to hang on the head or tie up. And he's much better off
and
not getting into a
throwing
muscle situation. That's
just
right where
happened.
He fell, yeah.
Fighting it tough down there, though. Down to the 35-second mark left in the second period. And there's your fall. So, First fall of the night will be Brandon Hale of Conneaut at the 3:27 mark of the match. And that's going to put Conneaut up by a score of 12-9 in the team score. Yeah, forgive me, Coach. I had to put my glasses on for a minute to see those little green numbers on the scoreboard.
We'll have to have a little larger numbers on that scoreboard for you.
Okay, so now we're at the 145s, and we've got Nate Zawoski from Conneaut. He's a sophomore, and he's out against Aaron Galuski, a junior from Harvey. Takedown finished on the line, which is out of bounds in wrestling, so we're going to go back to neutral here. Aaron's a junior. He's had a little injury and illness problem this year, but looks like they've got him healthy tonight. Nice deep shot that he wasn't quite able to finish on. Zawoski spins around behind for the takedown, makes it 2-0. And then into the quick tilt.
It's a rarity that anyone gets pinned with a tilt, but it is a situation where you get a takedown and you get a quick turn to the back and you're up by four or five points, and then you have a lot more options.
Yeah, we got three on the near fall and an escape out of bounds here, so now it's 5-1 in favor of Zawoski. Thank you. Easy for you to say. Aaron's working his setups.
There's a situation where
looking for that spladle, and he's got it, folks.
Oh my gosh. It's a great counter to the single leg that the Conneaut wrestler attempted.
He's either going to get his hip broken here or they're going to break this in a stalemate. The head's trapped in there. If Aaron can get, he gave the takedown. If he can get that leg elevated and get some back exposure here.
He's trying to fight him to turn him to his back, but at the same time try to keep him in bounds.
Nice catch. Nice catch. That's
right.
That's an all or nothing move.
Zawoski might be a little more timid to take a shot like that next time.
Maybe keep him off that single, go to something else. Okay, so that runs our score to 5. Here we go. We're going to have a caution on Aaron. A little false start there. That runs our score to 5-3. We've got 19 seconds left in the first period.
Aaron's a little bit too high, and once again he's attempting to.
All he's got to do is hold on for
turn.
6 more seconds here. Keep that head buried. Run the period out. Looks like he's going to make it, and we're going to finish the first period with a score: Conneaut 5 and Galuski of Harvey 3. Okay, Conneaut defers their choice in the second period to Harvey, and Aaron is going to take down position to start the second period.
Aaron's a scrambler. He keeps moving. He comes up with different things, and if you can keep moving and not get your hips trapped on the mat, you can still score points. You're a threat. Right off the whistle, Aaron missed his hand control, and once he came back up to his feet, he was able to recover, get a hold of those, but by that time he was out of bounds.
Looks like Zawoski's going to take the optional start here. But instead of kicking him, he jumped right into a bundle, a forearm pull-through move, and it's getting back exposure out of it. Coach, you think sometimes when the bottom man realizes the top guy's taking the optional that they let up just a little on their stand-up, figuring they're going to get the point and go to neutral, and you can occasionally get caught and shot like this.
I think Aaron was also caught there. Aaron had a false start. He moved his right leg out.
And expected a whistle that he didn't get. Yeah.
Right, so he's coming back in, and he was kind of frozen one spot when the kid hit that.
We have a fall at 27 seconds of the second period, and that is going to put Conneaut up 18-9. Now we're on to the 152 pounders. This is another one of Harvey seniors, Rory Sullivan. Rory spent the first half of the season at 162, and he's wrestling Adam Kopasz, a junior from Conneaut. I see by the sheet here, Mr. Kopasz has only one loss on his record this year. He's returning just a qualifier. Got in pretty deep on that leg. Let's see what Rory can do with him here. Tried a sit kick over, and I don't think he got enough momentum going to finish it. It's going to make two-point takedown for Kopasz. That'll make it 2-0. And here come the boots.
It's a little different. You get people who throw the legs. Some people run the upper body part of the body, run their arm bars. Adam, I believe that he and his brother are both running backs for the Conneaut football team. You know, when you throw the legs like this, it does wear down the opponent.
And he'll start working the power halves and head combinations like this one here, and it tends to wear you out pretty fast if you're trying to get out of it.
That was a good call by the official.
We have a basic punch to the face here. Wait a minute.
Well, he called it an illegal hold.
He called it on Sullivan.
On Sullivan?
It's 3-0.
I don't know. I'm with you, Jeff. I thought the way he took it back.
I thought the cross face.
I thought it was going to be potentially dangerous and, you know.
Potentially deadly.
Yeah, he can talk to us later about what he was thinking. Not what you and I were thinking. Rory needs some hand control here. One of the things that you want to do is make sure you can control your opponent's hands. That really negates what he can do. Nice way to recover.
I've just
been
informed by Harvey's bench that it should be 2-1. They've got the points on the scoreboard up for the wrong kid, which I think justifies our opinion of what that move was all about.
Okay,
they'll get it fixed for us in a minute here.
Well, we were right then. That's always good. Comforting. Restores my confidence in the official.
Joe, I was under the impression that during your illustrious career, you were known as a friend of officials.
I'll tell you what, you know, so many coaches get on these officials and,
hold on,
you know, they're
we're
doing
it. Okay. My mistake. The point was against Sullivan. I'm not sure why, but I'm going to attempt to find out here.
I think he said the way he brought the crossface across, I didn't see any fault with that. He's not the one who is going to receive the blow, I guess. Rory's running the head and arm here. He keeps a lot of pressure, hooks the ankle. He's trying to work the...
Okay, I've been given an explanation to that call. He called illegal pressure against the knee, against Sullivan from Harvey, which is an interesting call when you're going to your back. The punch to the face, I guess, was no big deal.
Well, it depends where you're looking. I think in wrestling especially, and you officiate, Jeff, you know, I think officials really try to protect the wrestlers from any harm. You're not allowed to go against a joint.
Absolutely. And the safety of the contestants is the primary function of the official out there. But
he may have seen that before anything else and
must
just
have.
Called that.
Must have.
You know, I don't want to suck up to the official, but
you're
I'm
not
a little
you're
surprised.
You're retired now, Coach. Go ahead. Suck up all you want.
I am still surprised with that call.
Kopasz trying to flip the legs back in there. Rory doesn't want to come up and give him too much of an opening here. Here comes that cross-face bundle again. He's going to try to pull that forearm through. Kick right to the back. Rory's not going to give him the opportunity to tie up the arm. Wise decision. Probably we should have had a stalemate on there. Oh. Spoke too soon.
Well, the situation there... I thought Rory was doing a nice job, and, you know, I agree with you. Probably should have been a stalemate. But
that's how fast it changed.
It changes rapidly, and you know, it's like Mitch Clark from Ohio State. He's very good with the legs, and you know, once your head comes up, he can turn you quickly.
Well, that's what we just saw there. The fall came at 3 minutes and 50 seconds. 1:50 in the second period. That's going to take our score to 24-9, Conneaut. And it'll move us to the 160-pound weight class, where David White, a junior from Harvey, will be wrestling Jared Davin from Conneaut. Mr. Davin has spent some time at the art store over the summer, judging by the amount of ink he's wearing on his upper arm. Caught on a shot there, comes back up. And here comes Davin in on the single. David's kicking the hip through, trying to get him broken off of his base. He's got that gut wrench in, trying to get his leg back.
David's fighting to keep his hip up. As long as he can keep his hips up, it's really, you're not going to be able to score the takedowns.
At this point, he wants to get some pressure on top of that head with his free hand. There you go. Push it right back under the kid's own arm.
Okay. Dave's been able to come on top of.
Yeah, nice hip work.
Right.
Very nice. Hit him buried for a second there. And he could score. Just needs to pound that hip in a little bit.
Dave's trying to work that cross face.
This is probably
a power
good
half
opportunity, too.
Yeah.
And there we have it. So we'll go back to neutral here with no score. 35 seconds left in the first period. I think Dave wants to just keep attacking that leg. Don't let this kid tie his head up and burn clock.
Devin's a sophomore, and you know, one of the things I think you see with younger wrestlers is they'll try to tie up your hands. They're a little scared or not the most confident, and there he used it to his advantage, finished the takedown.
Dave White trying to scoot around to get the reversal here at the buzzer, and he gets
he
it
just
at
got
the
it.
Buzzer.
Way to fight for it.
Tie the score up 2-2 going into the second period. Nice little piece of work in the last 12 seconds there. Okay, Conneaut deferred their choice, and David took neutral to start the second period. He's gotten a couple good shots off if he can finish one of these. Cleanly, there you go. No. Boy, he hit that nice little snap down and then got caught off balance onto his hip. Gives up a quick takedown. Head must have shrunk during the match here. That headgear slipped right down over it. Didn't quite get that firearm clear. Just keep fighting those hips up.
Davin's going to have to move up. Yeah. Right now he's staying on the hips, and he's going to get hit for stalling.
Well, we hope.
We hope so, but you know, Dave has to get some hand control.
Once you lock that ankle in by stepping over it, that's even a more effective stall.
There's no way he's going to be able to turn Dave unless he comes off the hips and gets out more towards the front.
And I think that's the plan.
Oh, yeah. They used to have riding time in high school.
Here we go. And I think the referee must be reading your mind, Joe.
Well, you know, I always get a little bit upset when somebody's writing the kid.